I'm Harry Charles, I'm 21, I'm a professional show jumper riding for Great Britain.
Hi, I'm Julie Andrews.
Hi, I'm Joe Stockdale, I'm 20 years old and I'm based in Northampton.
I've been visiting Horse of the Year show since I was 5 years old. First of all as a spectator, then later as a groom, and then fortunate over the last 15 years to be a competitor.
Hoy's a very special show for me. It was probably one of those first internationals where, actually it's the biggest international I've done, and that combined with the crowd and the atmosphere they have there, actually it was a hell of an experience, and it was what really sort of swayed my decision to go down the riding route.
I first went to watch my father, who competed in international classes from the 60s through to the 80s. Then my sister competed, and then I was in the Young Riders first. I've competed in all the national Young Horse Finals, the Fox Hunter, great honour to be partaking in that. And then over the last 6 years, I competed in the international competitions.
My best memory of competing at Hoy's probably would have been my first year there. I never really expected to have any results. I was just sort of going there and was happy to be there. But luckily I took Dini here with me and we managed to win the five fence challenge, a joint win. So that's probably my best memory to date of jumping at Horse of the Year show.
My best memory of competing at Horse of the Year show, I would say, would have to be in 2014. Our whole family had an amazing year there. I won the 148 championship. For me, that was my best memory. Winning that class was amazing. And Sienna also winning 128s was a weekend I think the whole family wouldn't really forget.
And the feeling of jumping a clear in the evening classes is amazing. To be announced as a national champion, to walk in with everybody, was one of the nicest memories I will have. For me, the best class would have to be the leading jumper. It's the Grand Prix of the show. It's a class that as long as I can remember, people have been trying to win it.
I think at the end of the day, the Grand Prix tops it. The atmosphere you get for that, and you know, just the general status of actually being able to compete in that Grand Prix and being contention winning it, I think is something very special. And
the Grand Prix is the biggest money, the best sport you'll get all week. It's one that everyone aims for and wants to win, so winning that is really the highlight of the week.
Everybody wants to qualify for Hoy's. It's been probably most people's lifelong ambition to take part there. When you qualify, it's an amazing achievement. It's a fantastic feeling because it's so hard to do.
Hoy's a very special show, not just for me, but for actually all international competitors that go there. When you think about the atmosphere you get and with those numbers of crowds in that small arena, the feeling when you canter into the ring is something really special, and it's what really people do this job for.
You get there, everything feels different. It's just a great feeling. It's the best show in the world.
46,200 pounds. 16 come forward to the final round of the leading show jumper of the year. They start over fence 14. Fence 14, one in reverse. Then 15, up to the top end, the vertical. Then they come round the corner, 7A and 7B, right in the middle, vertical to the oxer. Then, towards the bottom end, the Downing Street windows, fence number 3. Fence 4, the Abbey Road fence, with the water tray underneath it. Fence number 6, the lovely musical fence, fence 6. And then 12B is the last, the butterfly fence is the last. Good luck to them all. They start in reverse order of merit. We've got youth, we've got experience, and we've got superstars here in the leading show jumper of the year. Who is going to adorn that famous trophy tonight? And then the wonderful finale to round off the most fantastic Horse of the Year show 2019. Good luck to all 16. Here's the first.
Joining us, the first of the British riders, the first of these amazing young talents on display here tonight in the leading show jumper of the year. The rider that took that silver medal at those Youth Olympic Games in Buenos Aires last year, with Molly Ostrom and his father's Elkar VE. The first to go, Jack Whitaker, Great Britain.
Well, bad luck tonight, but good luck for this young man. No doubt about it, he's going to the top of the line in the world of international show jumping. Only 18 years of age, and it is two fences down, but remember this young man's name, and his name is Jack, and it is Jack Whitaker. Bad luck tonight, good luck, Jack.
Staying with young British talent and a lady that has already proved just how good she is winning here at the Horse of the Year show. The second in with Jeff Ten Halvin, Georgia Tame, Great Britain.
Went down to the last on six. That's a big vertical, 36.05. Jumped the Abbey Road fence in 24.5. So the first clear for Great Britain, Georgia Tame and Jeff Ten Halvin.
We started with strong young British talent, now strong young Dutch talent. A rider that has taken silver at two European Youth Games at both junior and young rider level. Here there with Seeker. It is Jens Verkunsven for the Netherlands.
Eight jumping and two time penalties. The time allowed in this second round, the jump off against the clock, 45 seconds. So they pick up a time penalty, a couple of time penalties as well. 10 there, but great to have him with us here at the Horse of the Year show for the first time. Bad luck tonight, Jens van Grunsven and Sika for the Netherlands.
Four challenges for Ireland here in the leading show jumper of the year tonight. The first of which with this man, riding Gentleman VH Veldhof, David Simpson, Ireland. 36.05, the leading time.
Seconds quicker, give him a cheer, David Simpson, Gentleman Ireland. So time to beat Gareth, 33.43.
Yeah, and he landed over the Abbey Road fence on 22 seconds, just to give us a little bit of a clue as to see if the others are in touch at that point on the track. 33.43 as now the challenge from Belgium with Hocus Pocus de Messiet. It is Arnaud Duhem, Belgium.
Just a wonder, those number 10 windows going down, 40.47 for the man who's paid his very first visit to the Horse of the Year show, Arnaud Duhem and Hocus Pocus. Give him a round of applause, been really good to have him with us here at the Horse of the Year show. So, Ireland, Great Britain, the two clears, the fastest time, 33.43.
Back to Ireland we go, and to a man that's been right up there in some big Grand Prix, including a Kashka Estoril on the London Jean Global Champions Tour this year, with Jay Davis's Egalani, Michael Duffy.
Comes home, finishes on a score of 8. 43.3 there for Michael Duffy and Egalini. So they drop down. Ireland still leading David Simpson and Gentleman, 33.43.
On we go to the next, and it's Ireland. We stay with this partnership have been truly sensational in 2019. What can they do tonight in the leading show jumper of the year? 33.43, the time that tops the board for David Simpson. Here now with his own and John Hales as SFS Aristio, Anthony Condon, Ireland.
Don't see that very often. He's been in great form this week, he really has. First and two, second and third here at the Horse of the Year show, but not tonight, but a great Horse of the Year show. Thank you, Anthony, and thank you to John Hales, FSF Aristio for Ireland.
David Simpson's really put the pressure on. He has really applied a very tough target, 33.43 as the time to beat, and it's certainly making them think out there in this final round of the leading show jumper of the year. Never, though, rule this lady out when it comes to going against the clock. Always quick. What will she do with Jalala O.L., Louise Saywell, Great Britain?
Oh, the last goes. What a shame. 38-23 would have gone third and does go third, but it is four faults, the last going down there for Louise Saywell and Jelena. And as Gareth said, you know, the real pressure has been put on because of that super fast round of David Simpson's and Gentlemen. And that time to beat, remember, is 33.43. We have riders from Great Britain, from Ireland, and from France still to go. We've got eight left to go in the jump off against the clock, the second round in the leading show jumper of the year. And at the moment, £15,700 is heading Ireland's way with that time of 33.43.
Certainly is. David Simpson at the top of the moment, Georgia Thames sitting in second, and that round of Louise Saywell's just put her in to third.
Gareth, we're now off to France with the time to beat of 33.43.
Certainly are, and what a challenge this man has proved to be. He's been in scintillating form. The first of the final eight into this final round with Utopia Villeneuve. It is Max Thurinon, France.
Up and over the last, Max Thurinon, 34.46, seconds slower than David Simpson's, but one fence down puts them into fourth spot at the moment. Merci, Max. Merci beaucoup. So, Ireland, Great Britain, France into third, and then Louise Saywell drops down into fourth. Seven left to go.
To the first of those, and to the next of the rising British talents heading our way now. This partnership jumped double clear in the Grand Prix of Switzerland in St. Gallen this year. What a day that was. What will they be able to do tonight? With Susan Larsson's Imagined Amuse, James Wilson, Great Britain.
Super round of jumping, 36.08 there for James. They go into fourth with that second last fence going down. James Wilson and Imagine Demus. That a ride of and owned by Susan Larson. So they're into fourth in the leading show jumper of the year. Six left to go. One for Ireland, five for Great Britain, and Ireland at the top of the tree.
And it's Ireland that go next. This man won the big Grand Prix at the Longchi Masters of Hong Kong earlier in the season. Here tonight with GC Champagne's Bouchy, Dennis Lynch, Ireland.
The man is pure class. 36.94 goes third. Ireland first and third. So he's third in the leading show jumper of the year. Dennis Lynch and the Onyx Consulting's GC Chopin's Bouchy for Ireland. Still, that time of 33.43 is the target to beat. Now it's Britain all the way. Five left to go.
And you've got to remember as well, they're coming back in reverse order of time from the opening round. Every chance, the quicker rides are towards the end of this draw. Three wins here 12 months ago. He's looking to finish on a high in 2019. Here then with Valkiry de Zance, Harry Charles, Great Britain.
Has he done it? Has he done it? Ah! Oh. 1 second exactly over that time. Give him a round of applause. He's second in the leading show jumper. David Simpson breathes again. And then there were four.
What can this lady do? Has she got the speed here tonight? The horse is certainly appropriately named. Tonight then on Ayrton. Good luck. Julie Andrews, Great Britain.
She's jumped a double clear in the leading show jumper of the year and goes into fifth. Give her a very big round of applause. Well done to Julie Andrews, Ayrton the fourth.
87, 2004, will he do it again in 2019? 33.43 to beat for this man. here with Strides Hilanasterne, Michael Whitaker, Great Britain.
It's so, so close. Oh! He goes third. He tried his hardest. He really did. Give him a very big round of applause. Michael Whitaker, Strides Hilanasterne. David Simpson has two to wait, and it's not over yet. Time to beat is 33.43. And do stay with us for the prize giving and for the finale. All the stars of the 2019 Horse of the Year show are with us for the finale. Two to go.
The Whitaker name hasn't appeared on the trophy since 2009. This man's cousin, Ellen, won it on that occasion. He's had an amazing 2019. What's he going to do? Here with Catwalk the Fourth, Robert Whitaker, Great Britain.
He's got a lot of jumping this winter still to come. He really has. Give him a very big round of applause. He won the Puissance last night. Bad luck there for Rob Whitaker and Catwalk the Fourth. Ireland, Great Britain, Great Britain, Great Britain, Ireland. Gentleman Van Hit Veldhof is in the lead for David Simpson. The time to beat is 33.43, and we're down to the final one. Is the fairy tale on? Cross your fingers, cross your toes, cross everything. Because this young man deserves it.
Last to go. In the leading show jumper of the year, with Gunner, Joe Stockdale, Great Britain.
He's such a talented young man, he really is. It's not tonight, his brother Mark is on the golf course as well. But bad luck there for Joe Stockdale. And so, ladies and gentlemen, stay with us for the prize giving and for the finale. You won't want to miss it. The winner and the leading show jumper of the year 2019, David Simpson and Gentleman Ireland. The leading show jumper of the year at the Horse of the Year Show 2019, David Simpson, Gentleman VH Veldhof, Ireland. My lords, ladies and gentlemen, may we ask you to please stand for the national anthem. The leading show jumper of the year 2019, David Simpson, Gentleman VH Veldhof, Ireland. Delighted to welcome Venetia Williams to present the Jorrocks Trophy to the leading show jumper of the year, David Simpson, Gentleman Ireland. In second place, fabulous round, Harry Charles and Irina Abramovich's Valkiry de Zance, Great Britain. In third, Michael Whitaker and Wendy Clements' Strides Hilanasterne. In fourth, what a Horse of the Year show she has had. Georgia Tame, Jeff Ten Halvan, Great Britain. Super to see this man back at the Horse of the Year show. Dennis Lynch and G.C. Chopin's Bushy, Ireland. Julie Andrews, what about that round? Super fast, Ayrton the fourth. For France, Max Tirois and Utupi Villeneuve for France. And James Wilson and Susan Larson's Imagine de Muse, Great Britain. Delighted to welcome Dyer Buffnott now, the Chief Executive of Retraining of Race Horses, to step forward and present the Mark Wheaton Trophy to the winning owner, not here tonight. It is the BVBA KW horses, but receiving it, David Simpson. And now we come to the Fred Harthill Memorial Trophy, the Penwood Forge Mill Trophy. And it does go to the leading British points winner, the leading British winner here at the Horse of the Year show. Very well done indeed, to the young lady who's based in Sussex, to Georgia Tame, Great Britain. Presenting that, David Andrews, on behalf of Andrews Bone. And David Andrews and Simon Bone, the two partners in this wonderful surface manufacturer, Andrews Bone. Thank you guys for everything that you do for the horse world, and well done to Georgia Tame, the leading British rider at the Horse of the Year show. And delighted to welcome Jeff and Alison Osborne to step forward to make the presentation to our leading athlete. Alison won the Osborne Refrigerators Scurry Driver of the Year last night. Well done, Ali. But well done to this lady. She wins the leading athlete award, the leading rider of the Horse of the Year show. Georgia, step forward. Georgia Tame, the leading rider of the Horse of the Year show. And still the finale left to go. Do stay with us. It will be worth it, I can promise you. Thank you very much indeed to Jeff and to Alison Osborne. Thank you and well done. You've brought a smile to our face this week. Well done to Georgia Tame. And so, let's raise the roof. We'll see him back in the finale in a few moments' time, but it is his moment in the spotlight. The leading show jumper of the year, David Simpson, Gentleman VH Veldhof.
It's an incredible horse to ride, and I firstly have to thank the Vitek family for the opportunity to ride such an incredible horse. That, like, without the horse, we're nothing.
But I think you're right. You haven't had this horse that long.
No, I got him literally the Monday before the Hickstead Derby show. That was our first show together, and then a month later he won the Queen's Cup. A month after that he was double clear in the Nations Cup in Gion, and a month later he wins. He's very consistent on every month.
And obviously, looking at that jump off, there seemed to be one key moment into one of the early uprights.
Yeah, no, my guy, he has so much ability, it's incredible. So I knew he's not naturally a quick horse, he's a big jumper. So I thought I can nail every turn back, first distance, just be there. And if I go as tight as I possibly can, hopefully the other guys will, trying to catch me, will make mistakes.
And obviously, this is one of Britain's big classes. And how proud are you to have won this?
Oh, like, this is something I've watched since I was a kid. Like, to win this Grand Prix is just an incredible feeling, and just so happy to be part of what is Horse of the Year show.
And obviously, got to get you to talk about, what do you think of what the team did over in Barcelona as an achievement?
Absolutely incredible. What those guys pulled together and done, we're one of the best nations in the world right now, and we just weren't nailing it at the championships, not since the Europeans in Gothenburg, and the guys just done it. Kean, Dara, Peter and Paul, they just absolutely nailed it there.
It's going to be a tough team to try and get onto, is it? If you would have aspirations?
Yeah, no, we're, for such a small country, we really are strong in this sport. But it's better to be part of a good team than a strong part of a weak team. So.
Well, you can go away from here with a job well done. Presumably the indoor season now for this one.
Yeah, he goes to Oslo in 10 days for the World Cup up there, and then Helsinki the week after. So this is my first time riding him indoors, so I was come here, figure things out, and make sure we can nail it for Oslo.
Good start of the season. Yeah.
I'd just like to say everything we are doing at the minute is for a very close teammate of ours and a very good friend of ours, Kevin Babington, who's fighting a really tough fight at the minute, and it's for you, Kevin.
Well said. Thank you very much.